So let me now define the derivative a little bit more formally. Returning to the example we started with, average speed from time 1 to time 2 is the distance traveled during that time interval divided by the time interval itself. And then we can say, well, let t2, the second time, get closer and closer to t1. That's equivalent to saying, if I think about average speed as this, change in position over a change in time, let this time interval, delta t, get closer and closer to 0. So if I'm thinking in terms of this notation, delta s over delta t, I let delta t get closer and closer and closer to 0. I can't just plug in 0 because then it'll be dividing by 0, but I let it get closer and closer and closer to 0, and I monitor what this number becomes, what this ratio becomes. And the result is the instantaneous speed. And the notation for that often is ds over dt. So instead of these triangles, deltas, which means big change, we use these little d's, which mean instantaneous change. So finally, and a little bit more generally, let's think about the derivative of x. So here x could be any function that changes at all. This could be position, it could be temperature, it could be population. It's just some generic function that changes. It doesn't have to be position. And we could ask, how does it change instantaneously? So the derivative of x, dx dt, is the instantaneous rate of change at x. That's the key thing you need to know from this subunit. The derivative is the instantaneous rate of change. Let me write just a few other ways to picture this. It's also the slope of x of t. X of t could be a curve, but that's okay. We saw in the previous video how to think about slopes of curves. And for those of you who have had calculus, here's the formal definition. It's the limit as h goes to 0 of x of t plus h minus x of t over h, which I just like to think of as change in x over change in t, in the limit that these changes become very, very small. So again, the derivative is the instantaneous rate of change of x. It's telling you how fast x is changing, and you might get different values depending on the time. So this allows for a function x that's growing at different rates at different times. Lastly, just a little bit of notation. So this idea of a derivative is quite often denoted this way, which would be read x prime. And in physics and engineering, one often uses this notation, x dot, which stands for time derivative. In this course, I'll almost always use this first derivative. I might occasionally, maybe by mistake, use this one. I won't use this one at all, but you're likely to see this in other texts or papers, particularly if it's from the physics or engineering community.